Hey everybody. So now I'm going to go over classical conditioning, which is part of a chapter on learning. And this is with Pavlov's dog, if you remember reading about that. And so students get this confused as well. So remember, there are four steps to classical conditioning. So let's go over these again. So step one is the unconditioned stimulus, right? In the Pavlov study, this was the dog food. So here's the dog food. And the unconditioned stimulus is a natural thing that leads to a natural response. If it's a natural response, it'll be unconditional because it's natural. It's not conditioned. So the natural response to the food is salivating, which I'll put as this is drops of saliva. That's step one. Natural stimulus leads to a natural response. Step two is a neutral stimulus, which in the case of Pavlov was a bell. So this is my bell. A neutral stimulus leads to no response. No response. So the dog didn't salivate. The dog had no response. It was as if nothing had happened. And so unconditional is natural. Neutral has no effect. And then no response means that the dog doesn't respond any differently. Step three is you're just really combining both of these together. Is you had the unconditioned stimulus, which is, again, the dog food, which is just my bowl of dog food, paired with the neutral stimulus, which is the same stimulus from up here. So this is the bell. This is the bell that rings. And then this is leading to a neutral stimulus, unconditioned response. Sorry, this is still unconditioned response of the dog salivating. This is drops of saliva, right? So now it's the unconditioned stimulus with the neutral stimulus leads to an unconditioned response. So you're still getting the same effect that you were over here. The dog is now salivating due to the dog food, but you're pairing the neutral stimulus along with it. So all that's really happening is you're getting the neutral stimulus, you're adding it right over here. So plus the neutral stimulus, and this gives you your step three. All you're doing is moving this up here and everything else stays the same. Now, after consecutive pairings with the dog food and the bell, you ring the bell, give the dog food, ring the bell, give the dog food. A dog initially salivates due to the dog food, but after this pairing, and step four, you have the conditioned stimulus, which is now the bell. The bell leads to a conditioned response of salivating. So now step four is pretty much like step two, but now these two have become conditioned. Now this is the conditioned stimulus and the conditioned response. The reason is because it's not natural for a dog to salivate to the sound of a bell. You've conditioned the dog to do this. It's something that you have done that wasn't natural. Now let's use an example of real life. So imagine you are in a relationship with someone and seeing them, let's say if you hear their name, okay, if you hear their name this year, if you hear their name, naturally it'll lead for you to feel this sensation of your heartbeat beating, and you've been with them for a few weeks, and now whenever you hear their name, someone says their name, you naturally feel this physiological arousal of your heart beating. So this is the unconditioned stimulus, natural, leads to natural unconditioned response. This just happened naturally. And let's say number two, step two is a neutral stimulus, which could be a ringtone. So if you have a ringtone for this significant person of yours, when the ringtone rings, initially the ringtone has no effect. Right? So if you save their name, so whenever they call you, the specific ringtone rings, it has no effect. But when you get in a relationship with this person, whenever you hear their name, you have an unconditioned natural response, and the ringtone then, pairing their name with the ringtone, so now whenever you hear the specific ringtone on your phone and it's your significant other calling and you see their name, then you feel a physiological response. Again, I'm sorry, so here this was a neutral stimulus. Initially the ringtone had no effect, no response. This emoji shows really no emotion. But then when you pair their name with the ringtone, so whenever your phone rings, you hear that ringtone, you see their name, you feel a physiological response, your heart beating. So this is still the unconditioned stimulus, which is leading to the unconditioned response. Your body is responding this way due to seeing or hearing their name, and this is still neutral. But if you pair this several times, then just hearing that ringtone, just hearing that specific ringtone you have for that person will lead you to feel physiologically aroused, your heart rate beating, happy, and now this has now become the conditioned stimulus. This is the conditioned response. And now whenever, what's interesting is even if the relationship doesn't work out and you end up breaking up, you may have still been conditioned to whenever you hear this specific song that you programmed for their ringtone out in the mall or out in the park, you may still feel something physiological without realizing it. And without realizing it, you've conditioned yourself. And that's classical conditioning.